Hi there, my name is Charles Sorenson. I'm a partner in the law firm here. I've handled many cases over the years, and I think you'd be surprised to learn that quite often people end up doing things that hurt their own cases. So I want to share with you the top five things that I think you should do or not do when it comes to protecting the outcome of your case. The first thing is that people wait way too long to see a lawyer. You can lose evidence if you wait too long. You can lose the opportunity to get evidence. You can lose witnesses. People move, people leave. So if you think you should talk to a lawyer, then just do it. Just pick up the phone and call. They may say that you don't have a case, but the worst thing that you can hear is that you did have a case, but that you waited too long. The second thing is that many people wait too long to get medical treatment. People hope they're going to get better. They get distracted. They live their lives. They don't have the money. But it can hurt you when you go to make a claim. So go get checked out. Make it a priority. Now there are even some time deadlines that you need to see a doctor in order to be able to make a claim. Besides, it's important not just for you, but also for your family that you take care of yourself. The third thing is when people will hire inexperienced lawyers. There's really no reason to make that mistake today because you can go online and you can check out people. Experienced lawyers and their law firms have websites. Do that. Check out the website, just like you're doing right now. Also, ask your friends, ask neighbors who they've had good experiences with. If you have an inexperienced lawyer, it's going to hurt your case. The fourth thing is to be sure to not talk with your insurance company before you talk to your lawyer. I know that seems counterintuitive. They're your insurance company. They're supposed to be there when you need them. But too often, insurance companies do not have your best interests at heart. They're there to save money and to do everything they can do to build their case against you. So you need to learn to what your rights are before you talk with the insurance company. Now the last thing is posting inappropriate social media. I know you've heard that before about posting inappropriate things on social media, but many times people will even post inappropriate things on media even after they see their lawyer. Remember, if a lawsuit is filed, insurance companies will have access to it. Remember also that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Don't help the insurance company with what you think may be an innocent post. So a good rule of thumb is to not post anything on social media that you don't want shown to a jury one day if your case should not be settled and should go to trial. Those are my top five pieces of advice on how not to hurt your case. We're here to answer your questions. Go to our website or give us a call. We can help you from the start of your case. We'll make sure that you have the best possible outcome. Be safe and be smart.